Welcome dear friends. Today's topic is ATP-ADP cycle. Myself Vivek Suresh Jede, Head and Assistant Professor, Department of Biochemistry, Arts and Science College, Pulgaon. Dear friends, you see the structure of ATP and ADP on screen. ATP and ADP have both adenine group in their structure, ribose sugar in their structure, and phosphate group in their structure. ATP have 3 phosphate group in their structure, while ADP have 2 phosphate in their structure. So ATP is known as adenosine triphosphate, while ADP is known as adenosine diphosphate. They are interconvertible to each other. When phosphate is removed from ATP, it converts it into ADP, and when phosphate is added to ADP structure, it is converted into ATP. Let's see what is the structure of ATP. ATP is adenosine triphosphate. It is also known as energy currency of the cell. ATP provides energy for both, that is energy consuming endergonic reactions, as well as energy releasing, that is exergonic reactions. If you see the structure of ATP, you will find that ATP has 3 phosphate, that is alpha phosphate, beta phosphate, then gamma phosphate. Also, it has the ribose structure and adenine structure. And if you see the structure very carefully, you will find that they have 4 negative charges on their structure. So it is also known as ADP4- structure. Next, that is ADP. ADP is known as adenosine diphosphate. It is also known as adenosine pyrophosphate, that is APP. It is an important organic compound in metabolism and essential to flow the energy in living cells. ADP can be converted to the adenosine triphosphate and adenosine monophosphate. So it is an intermediate compound, while conversion from ATP into ADP, and then it is into AMP. See the structure of ADP. You will find that there are only 2 phosphate group in their structure, and if we remove the hydrogen atom from the phosphate group, we will find that it has 3 negative charges on their structure. Interconversion of ATP into ADP. If you see this diagram, you will find that when phosphate is removed from ATP, the energy is liberated, and that energy is used for various purposes, and during that reaction ADP is developed. When ADP gain energy in the form of phosphate, they form the phosphate bond, and that will the regeneration of ATP. In this way, ATP and ADP interconvergence takes place, and for that various energy is used, and that is the main form of this energy is the chemical energy, which are withdraw from food, which the living organisms use for their day-to-day activity. ATP-ADP cycle. In this cycle, you will find that when ATP break its bond, it will release lot of amount of energy as well as 1 phosphate group and convert into the ATP. Here in yellow portion, you will find that is the phosphate which is removed from the ATP and then ADP is formed. When this ADP regain the energy or phosphate from outside or from the system through the processes, that is glycolysis, TCS cycle, etc., it will regenerate the ATP. And when it gives the energy, the energy is utilized for various cellular activities and biosynthesis purpose. So this type of ATP-ADP cycle is continuously going on inside the cell. It is the simple representation of ADP-ADP cycle. In examination, you will go with either that diagram or this diagram. In this diagram, you will find that the with simple structure, that is phosphate and energy is removed, and because of that ATP is converted into ADP, and when it get phosphate and energy, that will form or resynthesize ATP molecule. How ATP-ADP cycle is operated? From where the phosphate comes, that is the actual major question. This phosphate comes from succinyl COA, phosphoenol pyruvate, 1,3 bisphosphate, oxidative phosphorylation processes, and creatinine phosphate, etc. If you see the upper structures or upper molecules, that is all the energy, high energy compounds. And these high energy compounds will able to give the phosphate to the ATP, and that phosphate is utilized to convert into ADP to operate the ATP-ADP cycle, and that phosphate then given to the low energy compound such as glucose 6-phosphate, other pyrophosphorylation reactions, endergonic processes, glucose 1,6-bisphosphate, glycerol 3-phosphate reactions, etc., etc. Means if you see the diagram carefully, you will find that the high energy compound which are having high potential of energy transfer, that gives the phosphate atom to the ATP molecule, and the same atom or of the phosphate is given to the low energy compounds to operate the processes. So here is the combination of exergonic as well as endergonic reactions which are carried out inside the cell, and all the energy is fulfilled or flow from high energy compound to low energy compound through ATP-ADP cycle. So in short note, you have to mention this diagram for your better impression. Next question is, what is the importance of ATP-ADP cycle inside the cell? Why it is very important? If you see the ATP-ADP cycle, you will find that ATP is regenerated from ADP, and ADP is synthesized from ATP. So during that energy conversion takes place, and this energy conversion is used for various kinds of chemical reactions or for biosynthesis, detoxification, thermogenesis, that means heat production inside the body, ion transport inside or outside the cell, and muscle contraction, that means for walking and talking activities. So this energy comes from the ATP degradation. ATP gives its energy for these energy purposes, and from where this energy comes, that is comes actually from the energy source, that is what we eat, that is carbohydrates, proteins, lipids, that will give the energy, and that energy is utilized to form ATP. And when ATP is formed inside the body, that energy currency, that money is utilized for various biological activities by the cell. Next are the references. For this topic, you can refer U. Satyanarayana Biochemistry by U. Satyanarayana, Leninger's Principle of Biochemistry by Nelson and Cox, Harper's Biochemistry, etc. With this remark, thank you. You can read all about the ATP-ADP cycle in your textbook as well as from reference books. And thank you for patiently listening to the lecture.